All right, so let's go ahead and look at factoring expressions using basically what we call the guess and check method. Not exactly guessing, we're using our numbers here and kind of plugging in. Okay. Before we get started on the problem, you want to go ahead and see if there's any GCF, a common factor between all the terms. There is one in this case. They don't have any number I can divide, but they do all have an X. So I'm going to divide them all by X. And I just go ahead and bring that to the front. So I get X times 4X squared plus 37X plus 63. And here, we're going to go ahead and leave the x alone. Just leave that x in the box. And then we're going to factor the inside right here, the 4x squared trinomial. Okay. And it just might take a couple tries. If you do like the a times c method or the little diamond, it's going to be a little tough because the numbers are so big. Like 4 times 63 and 37 in the middle. So what we want to do is actually go ahead and use the guess and check method by using the A term here, the first one, 4x squared, the coefficient. We want to see that 4, well, the only way I can multiply to 4 would be either 4 times 1 or I could also do 2 times 2. So I have two different scenarios there. There's always that one where it's times one, is keep that in mind. Then the last one there, 63. Okay. 63, there's always the one method. So 63 times one. With big numbers, probably not the one there to get 37. And then yeah, 9 and 7 there. Okay. So those are my two different options. We usually want to try the options that you split them apart. So like here would be 2 and 2 and 9 and 7. Okay. Try those first before doing the one because those are more common. So let's try to do that. So you kind of either want to write not so dark or just be ready to cross it out because it is guessing. And then if it doesn't work, we cross it out. Okay, so these are going to be our first numbers here, the red ones. Let's try 2x and 2x. And then I need to pair it up with these. I'm not going to pair it up with the 63 and 1. I'm going to go ahead and do the 9 and 7. And I got to be careful where I put those. Well, in this case, actually, they're both the same, so it doesn't matter. Then I just go ahead and put the 9 and 7 in the next slots there. So that was my guess part. Okay. And then it's real important we do both parts here. We got to check and see if this really makes sense. Okay. To check and see, we kind of do like a smiley face here. I just go ahead and multiply and see if I get this middle term right here, the 37x. So I go ahead and multiply. Kind of like a maybe a nose and a smiley face for the check. Nine times 2x, I get 18x. 2x times 7, I get 14x. I go ahead and add those up, and I get 32x. So does that work? No, I didn't get 37x. So that guess did not work. Okay. Yeah, then it's over. Try to guess on the first try. And the more you work at it, the more you're going to realize how to guess the first time. Okay. 63 and 1 probably can't use that. How are we going to get 37x from all positive 16 to 1? So what I really need to change is not the 9 and 7, but the 4 and 1. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and try again. I still have my x out here. And I'm going to try the 4 and 1 instead. 4x and 1x, basically, or just x. I'll write the 1x there. Okay. Now, it's important where I put the 9 and 7. If I put the 9 on the right parentheses, it's going to be multiplied by 4. And if I put the 7 on the 9 on the other one, it's going to be multiplied by 1. Well, if I put it here, I'll get 9 times 4, 36, and I'll 7 times 1, that's too much. So I want to put the 9 in the first slot here. So I go ahead and do that. Put it over here, plus 9 and plus 7. And I kind of do that nose and the smiley face again. I get 9x. 28x, and those two do add up with what I need, 37x. So that's going to be your correct factorization, and we just kind of make a box around it then. So you've all done this in Algebra 1, either using that for line method, A times C, and B method. That's that little diamond or the box. But here, it doesn't work that well because we get real big numbers when you do that here. Let's go ahead and look at another example here. Number 2. So first, again, when we're factoring, always check and see if they have something in common. See for points, who can give me a hand and tell me what's in common here? Yeah, 3, very good. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and divide everything by 3 there. Divide everything by 3. So I bring the 3 to the front. And I get 9r squared plus 24r minus 20. Make sure I do that division correctly there. Then we want to go ahead and factor this. So we have to look at our beginning term and our last term to figure out that factorization. 9r squared and negative 20. In the middle, we just kind of add 2. So 9, we're going to have two possibilities. 9 times 1 or 3 times 3. Okay. 20. We have a couple possibilities. We have 5 times 4, 2 and 10, and then the last one there, 1 times 20. And then the reverse, yeah, always the reverse case as well.
Yeah.
Okay. Now for this one, we got also it's important to notice that this is a negative 20. So when I'm calculating that, one of these two numbers has to be negative. Okay. So either the 5 is negative or the 4 is negative and so on. So it might take a couple of guesses here to figure this one out. So I go ahead and make my parentheses. And I usually want to start off trying the ones that are not the one. So I'm going to do the 3 and the 3. So I try out those. 3R and 3R. And then I'll try the 5 and 4 case. Well, 5 and 4 is really close. Actually, I need a 24R. So it'll be tough to get 24R from 5 and 4 where one of them is negative. And I'll just kind of illustrate how I mean by there. The bigger number definitely has to be positive because I want a positive number. So let's make the a negative 4 and positive 5 to get negative 20. But as you kind of get used to this, that one wasn't really a good start because you'll see that they're real close and you're not going to get 24R with the difference there. But I just want to illustrate that here. Again, I'm trying to get this middle. Negative 4 times 3R, I get negative 12R. And 3R times 5, I get 15R. I go and add those up and I get 3R. So not even close to the 24R. So this guess here didn't work. And they need quite a difference between the two numbers. If I swap numbers, it makes it even worse. I'll get a negative answer. That 15R change to negative, and this will be positive for the blue numbers there. So I'm going to go ahead and use the 2 and 10. I think that's a better choice. So let's try that one here. So I'm going to keep the 3R and 3R. I'll get 3R and 3R. And the 2 and 10. And it's important where I put the negative sign. I want the number to be positive, so I'm going to put the positive on the 10 and a negative on the 2. And then I go ahead and check this guess right here. Yes. On the number, it does. Like if I put the negative 10, that would matter. But if I put the 10 over here and the negative 2, that doesn't matter. Because they're both 3R in this case. Then I go ahead and multiply 10 times 3R, I get 30R. 3R times negative 2, and I get negative 6R. I add those two together. And I get what I need, the 24R that was up here. So that's my correctly factored form right there, and I just kind of make a box around it. So in this one, we got in two guesses. If I had to do them all, there'd be a lot more. But you can kind of eliminate the guesses by going through and just seeing what makes sense when you multiply them together. Again, we always have this kind of the nose and smiley face multiplication to check. All right, let's go ahead and look at one last example here, number three. You can keep this written. All right, so let's look at this one. 10, 47, and 42 have no numbers divisible into all of those. And they don't have a common variable either, so nothing to divide out here in the beginning. So I just jump to my factors. Factors of 10 would be 2 and 5 and 10 and 1. Factors of 42 would be 6 and 7, or of course the 42 and 1 case, and yeah, 2 and 21, yeah. Okay. We always want to try the ones where they're closer to each other. First, it's usually those cases more. So I'm going to go ahead and try the 2 and 5 and 6 and 7 first. So I didn't have any number in front to factor out. So I just write down my parentheses. And I need a negative 47 to multiply 2. So it's important to note that if I want a negative, but the 42 is positive, then both of the numbers on the 42 have to be negative. Like negative 6 times negative 7, that would be positive 42. Or negative 42 times negative 1, positive 42. Negative 2 times negative 21, positive 42. So both numbers have to be negative. So I make sure to include both numbers negative in there. Then for 10n squared, I'm going to multiply 5n times 2n. And then I want 47n. So it's kind of a larger number, so I'm going to make sure that my larger number goes to the 5 here. Or I can kind of do maybe some of the thinking in my head. Let's see. If I do 6 on the right one, 6 times 5 would be 30. And then 7 times 2 would be 14. So 30 and 14 wouldn't add up. So that one doesn't work. So I'm going to go ahead and put the 6 here and the 7 there. And I think that should work. Minus 7, minus 6. Go ahead and do my nose and smiley face to check. I get negative 14n. And oops, well, I said I wasn't going to try these, but I guess I did. Negative 30n, and that didn't work. The negative, you get negative 44n. So that guess didn't work. So I'm going to go ahead and just move these 6 and 7s around. I think that should work out just fine. I get 5n minus 6, 2n minus 7, I go ahead and multiply those two together. Here I get negative 12n. Here I get negative 35n, and those add up to what I need, the negative 47n. Okay, so I get my factored version there. All right, so to summarize the different factorizations, if you start off with something that looks like this, where they're both plus, then it's always going to factor into two pluses in the middle there. If you start off with something that has a negative and then a plus, like the one we just did, you're going to have two negatives inside the parentheses. And the other two cases, let's say if I have something that looks like this one right here, which actually I believe can't be factored. That one, when it has two negatives, then one of them is going to be negative and the other one's going to be positive. And if the last one's negative, then that's also, one's going to be negative and one's going to be positive. Doesn't really matter. The positive could go first, so the negative, you got to just have two of the signs. Okay? So if you have two positives, they got to be both positive. If the middle one's negative and the second one's positive, they're both negative. And then the other two cases, it's a mix and match, one negative, one positive.